Aleluia. Somebody say, God, be good to me. Somebody say, you brought me out. You brought me out of dark places. You brought us out of bad places. You brought us from the shadow of death. You brought us out of sickness. You brought us out. People have to pray. Somebody tell you, thank God. Somebody say, is it a thing? Too hard for God. Is it a thing? Too hard for God. Amen. Amen. Somebody said, I'm still here. Somebody said, I'm still here. Somebody said, I'm still here. I'm still here. Hallelujah. Somebody said, the will of God on my side. We're right there today. Hallelujah. We're going to go to the book of Matthew, chapter 5. Amen. And on to God. And get along my business. Give him praise on this morning. We come to bless him. We come to lift him up on this morning. Amen. We thank God for our pastor for this morning. Give my hand. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Amen. For my pastor, for my husband. We're going to praise on this morning. We're going to praise. Somebody say, God is good. All the time. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Somebody say, God is good. All the time. Hallelujah. Sometimes you go through stuff, you go through a humble experience. Go through stuff, come out meeting and yeah, still the same. Wow. When you go through stuff, it should bring you to an humble experience. Amen. I gotta humble myself under the hands of God. He was exhorting me due time to do well. Season. You know to praise, amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And I thank God for my husband, for my pastor. You know to praise God. Amen. He always showing me the right way and telling me the right things. Amen. 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 Praise. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm ready to praise. Amen. Matthew chapter 5. Amen. Amen. Matthew chapter 5. Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I thank God this season I feel God saying that he wants to be more humble.
Amen.
Amen. More humble. I don't have time to look at all the scriptures right now, but the book of James said, Don't run the evil for evil. Now I know about everybody. He said, I'm gonna tell them that. He said, don't run the evil for evil. And sometimes when people hurt us, make us mad, we want revenge. We want something to happen to them, we want God to get them.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm talking about your thoughts. Amen. And they don't hurt your feelings. They don't lie, don't you? Don't persecute you, don't told some stuff on you that were true. Amen. And being fake, that they with you, they not with you. Then you find out they out to get you or out to find your business and they use it to destroy you. And use what you said to put you down. And this, it do hurt being persecuted, being lied on, being judged. It do hurt. But then I'm God was dealing with me. He was saying, don't run the evil for evil. He said, you just humble yourself down and love people and treat them right and respect people. So good seeds. So good seeds, amen. And sometimes we're in a place where I'm not going to do this for them because they didn't do it for me. Or I'm not going to treat them right because they didn't treat me right. I'm not going to respect them because they didn't respect me. We go in on places. Amen. They're still running evil for evil. Amen. So I'm going through the Bible, so I'm going to humble myself down under the mighty hands of God. And I'm going to do it the way the Bible said, not by what my flesh said, not by what people said, or not by how I got angry, frustrated, or mad, or revenge. We had our mom sit down.
Amen.
Amen. And sometimes we want people to change. Sometimes we had to change first. Because we know everybody got something that needs to be changed. Everybody got something that you don't like. You have some stuff that people like about you. You have some stuff people don't like about you. And sometimes we wait on people to change, pray for people to change. And God said, we need to change. Somebody said a good word on this morning. Amen. You just show your love. You let your light shine. Then you let God work on the other person. Because if you're doing revenge, or auger and auger, y'all on the same level. Who's going to step down and be humble? Who's going to step down and take the blows? Who's going to step down and walk by faith and not by sight? Who's going to humble themselves under the mighty hands of God? And he will exhort you in due time and do what?
Season.
In due time and do season. Give God the praise, somebody. Tell him, thank you. Hallelujah. And then we had to examine ourselves. I said, God, anything with me, I told God to take it out.
Yeah.
Amen. We have to examine ourselves because we may be doing stuff might not be pleasing to God. So we have to humble ourselves down. So God, Take everything out of me that I like. And that is not your will. Amen. You have to pray for deliverance. Yeah. Amen. You can't do angry, angry, fight and fight, argue, argue. Amen. You got to let it go and just let them have it, put them in God's hand, and then God work it out. You go to the place, I'm going to tell you that. Because you know what? I don't know why church people judge people, because we all have things in our life. We all going through deliverance. We all need help. We all need a savior. So you can't judge people because we all got issues. We all working on ourselves. They go to praise. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody say, God is good. Somebody say, all the time. Let's go to the book of Matthew 5 and 6. Matthew 5 and 6. Somebody say, I got God on my side. Hallelujah. I got God on my side. If it weren't for God on my side, where would I be on today? Amen. I feel the power. I feel the anointing. I feel the Holy Ghost. Jeremiah says, like, fire! Oops. Circle going around in the wilderness, and I hear God on this morning. God said, "It won't shall I see, receive or shall I sight." I heard your prayer and I heard your cry, your God. And God said, "There's gonna be a change, gonna take place in your life on this year." Somebody say, "This year." Somebody say, "On this year." So this year, yes, Robosha. And see, sometimes you get persecuted, it'll make you cry. When you be locked down, it'll make you cry. When you get hurt, it'll make you cry. But I'm gonna cry to pass my test.
Amen.
Then it go off. See, sometimes you have to cry to pass your test. Sometimes you gotta be still and know that God is moving. And we all been hurt. You've been hurt by family, you've been hurt by friends, you've been hurt by people on your job, you've been hurt by church people, you've been hurt by a lot of people. And it'll build up. And then sometimes your body don't want to take so much. And sometimes you have a lot of stress. You're going to lunge out before you know it. You can say the wrong thing because you know it. Because you literally build up because you didn't let it out. And we can build up until it goes into something. It can go into curse. It can go into worn out. It can get into hot. Because it don't build up and you haven't released it yet. And see, this thing you got to forgive. Don't hold grudges because it built up. Amen. It make you curse before you know it. It make you go off before you know it. It make you say the wrong thing before you know it. You say, wait a minute, I didn't know that was in me. You don't talk about it. I thought that was out. Come on. You thought you were delivered in that area. You thought it was out. You thought it was out. And sometimes you came out with your mouth worse than it would have been. It was worse. Wait a minute now. Wait. I thought I was delivered worse than it would have been. Amen. Amen. So say amen.
Amen.
Amen. But God allowed us to see ourselves. We all need deliverance. We all need help. That's where people can't judge nobody. Nobody can